G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and I am on an empty viaduct server today to answer a question that I get asked quite often, and that is, Mr. Paladin, what is your mouse settings and what mouse settings should I use for Team Fortress 2? So first off the bat, what I want to say is this is a very difficult question to answer, only because you're really asking a different question. The question you're really asking is, what mouse settings should I have my settings at in order to perform well? Because I could tell you my mouse. I mean, my mouse is a Logitech G502. That's the wired version of the mouse. I do the wired version of a wireless version because I've had too many times where the battery's gone dead on me and it's upset game, so I just prefer to have the wire in all the time. If you don't like the wire, don't play with the wire, okay? Again, these questions are gonna be catered to you, whatever is best for you. Now, as far as my mouse settings are concerned, I can show you them as well. But the trouble with the settings that I'm using is it's not going to be the same for you, okay? Because, for example, my mouse has a couple of hardware settings on it. So at a flick of the button, I can change the sensitivity on my mouse. So if you even matched my settings here, it's not going to be the same for you. So you're just going to have to try it out for yourself and check it out. I like having the raw input just because I don't want anything interrupting the mouse signal going through. You know, I don't want any interruption. Like it's saying, it provides a more reliable mouse movement, right? It bypasses the control panel of Windows. So what do you want your mouse settings to be? First of all, I want you to go into any map. I just loaded up an empty bot map myself. Find something to look at. I'm going to look at this big sign here, right? And put your mouse in the dead center of your mouse pad. Lift it up and move it wherever you need it to. Now, I want you to take your mouse all the way to the left and then all the way to the right. And what you should be able to do is, without taking your mouse off of your mouse pad, you should be able to turn a full 180, well, a full 360 if you go full left and right, right? But you probably don't want to go too much further than that. Like, I could, if I really take it to the edge of my mouse pad, I could go all the way from here, and then if I take it all the way the other way, I'm going a little bit past the center, okay? Now, the reason you want to do that is for two reasons. One, when you're playing, you're going to get shot from behind, so you want to quickly react and boom, shoot them in the head. Right? That's the first thing you're going to want to be able to do. The second thing is, oftentimes you're engaged with an enemy, and let me find a good object here. Let's just pretend for a moment, because I don't want to spawn in any bots and I don't want to do this in a game, that this object here is an enemy. Now, we're going to want to be able to have our mouse settings so we can circle strafe around them and keep tracking them without lifting the mouse off of the mouse pad, right? Because if you have to lift off the mouse from the mouse pad while you're going around, you're looking more like this, and your aim's all over the place trying to track the enemy. Now, the only caveat I'll put on the mouse settings is, if you're a sniper type class, you're up here on a sniper ledge like this, but if you have really high mouse sensitivity, like you see right now, I've turned mine up a bit, but you're trying to land a headshot on something that's down there, sometimes that sensitivity is just way too high. That's where I might suggest having a mouse like the one I've got, where you can adjust the sensitivity down, so you can make it so that, hey, a large movement is not going to change the aim too much, so you can land those headshots. Or even if you want to look into some of the scripts where you change it to make it so that when you use your zoom button, you're also changing your mouse sensitivity on the fly, and that's not too hard to do in Team Fortress 2 and some other games. So let's say your aim is not the best. It's okay, you don't have to worry about that either, because there's several accommodations in several games. Like, for example, in Team Fortress 2, if your aim's not the best, just go heavy. I mean, it's more about positioning and watching out for your teammates and being where they need you rather than aim, because you've got so much bullet spread anyway that it's not like you're going to have a hard time hitting our dude over here, right? That is not going to be a problem. Overwatch is the same way. So what? You're not the world's best tracer, okay? You don't have the best tracking. Still aim for the head, right? But, you know, play something like Reaper or D.Va or Zarya that aren't in particular classes that worry about aiming 100% of the time. You just need to land those body shots with them. Now, if you do have the tracking abilities of a Saint, you know, go ahead and try Scout or something like that, or Tracer in Overwatch. But, you know, my reflexes are a little bit slow, and I don't know. I just don't groove on Scout and Sniper all that much. But hey, if that's your thing, knock it out. Go ahead, get that circle strafing down, get that twitch aiming down, get those kills. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.
Non più dry farfalon amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento a tuo cibo d'amor.